What is going on, everyone, over at the Search and Destroy Elite? My name is Kyle, and welcome back to some more awesome Search and Destroy action. What I have for you guys today is another episode in the Search and Destroy Challenge series, and wow, I just said Search and Destroy a lot. I'm not going to mention it anymore. What I have for you guys today is actually a 23-1 challenge gameplay, and honestly, I had no intention of even getting a score remotely close to this. I was actually aiming for like a 13 plus kill gameplay because that's all the challenge requested, and I ended up getting 21 kills, or not 21. I don't know why I keep saying 21. It was 23, which was probably one of my higher scoring Search and Destroy gameplays, but still, nothing is ever going to top my 21-0 with a shotgun. I don't think any gameplay I'm ever going to get on Call of Duty anymore is gonna top that one. But anyway, I'm gonna talk a little bit about the challenge first, then I'm gonna talk about the best way to approach getting a higher scoring gameplay, let's say getting at least 20 kills. So anyway, this challenge is a heavy recoil challenge, which was requested by a YouTuber by the name of Washington6PS3, and you guys remember that anytime during this video, if you have a challenge idea pop in your head, just throw it down in the comment section and I'll be sure to check it out. But anyway, the challenge was to use the MP5 silencer with extended mags, extreme conditioning, quick draw, dead silence, head use a throwing knife, concussion grenade, running with the assault streaks 5, 7, and 9. I went with the Predator, Attack Chopper, and the Reaper. Also had to get at least 13 kills. It was 13 or more kills and 2 or less deaths, and I end up, like I said, dropping at 23-1, which I didn't expect to happen at all, because really, the MP5 without kick just sucks so goddamn bad. I know Tyler was talking about it in a video with just using the MP5 in general. It's just not what it used to be, and honestly, they could buff it up all they want, but I don't think it's ever going to get to where it was before. So I'm hoping they bring back the MP5 in Black Ops 2. I know it's all futuristic and whatnot, but I really hope they have a weapon that is like the MP5 from Call of Duty 4, because that's really what I always expect it to be, and I always want it to be in every single Call of Duty game. That'd be pretty cool if they ended up bringing back those guns and having them play very similar to how they did in previous Call of Duty games, because that's really why I like using a lot of weapons I've seen before. It's because I kind of assume that I'm going to be able to play the same way that I can with them with other Call of Duties, but it never really ever works out. So anyway, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about getting 20 plus kill gameplays, or just getting 20 kill gameplays in general. And there's one thing that you really have to know. It is stressful, honest to God, just sitting down and playing for hours and hours just hoping to get a 20 kill gameplay. It's going to happen a lot. So if you ever set your mind on the fact that, you know what, I want a 20 kill gameplay, it's not going to happen as soon as you snap your fingers. It is something you're going to have to put a lot of time, you're going to have to put a lot of effort into, and you really just have to get lucky, because some of these situations and some of these circumstances that you run into in Call of Duty, and especially in Search and Destroy, it's really bullshit, and it's really stupid, and it is frustrating. And honestly, you are going to get good teammates, you're going to get bad teammates, you're going to get good enemies, and you're going to get bad enemies. And just getting in a situation where you're able to capitalize on having bad enemies and bad teammates, and being able to take advantage of every kind of situation, it doesn't happen a lot. I mean, getting 20 kills is pretty difficult, because you have to have all those circumstances going your way, and sometimes things don't go your way. Sometimes you may get knifed around a corner, or your bullets don't register automatically, or your connection is not up to par. It happens a lot. So one thing is really just to be patient, and just let the gameplay come to you. I know it kind of sounds stupid, and it kind of sounds really simple, but I know a lot of people, they put so much time and effort into recording a lot of Search and Destroy, and they set their standards so high that they get disappointed when they're not coming close to it. But it is really difficult, and I mean, also over here at the Search and Destroy, we can all agree that this game is very hard to play solo, and really the only way to get 20 kills playing solo is just getting lucky and getting in that lobby that everything goes right for you guys. So I mean, if you ever find yourself in a situation where you're like, you know what, I really want to get a 20 kill gameplay, just be patient, because honestly, the best thing you can have when playing Search and Destroy is being patient. I've noticed it a lot in my gameplays, is that rather than me rush in there, try and get as many kills as I possibly can all the time, it doesn't help me out that much. It doesn't really work out. It never, ever comes down to the fact where I'm dropping like 5, 6 kills every single round, because I either get caught with someone sitting in a corner, or someone just sitting in spawn, or just someone being able to predict my strategy for that map. So it's a little bit difficult trying to play solo a lot, so be really patient. And that's why I've been using a sit rep a lot lately, is just because I can wait a few extra seconds and just listen in, and if I hear anybody coming, I'm just not gonna run around a corner and sprint around and make myself look like a dumbass and get killed and get frustrated. So that is one thing I will highly recommend, guys. Patience is key in Search and Destroy, and it will help you get better, and it will help you get those higher scoring gameplays. But anyway, my name has been Kyle, and if you enjoy this challenge series, be sure to leave a like or just some positive support on the video, and I will talk to you guys in the next episode.